Hey there. Like usual, these tutorials assume you already know a good bit about modeling. This one will also require a little bit of Unreal knowledge. If you're just starting out, I suggest you find some beginner tutorials, otherwise you'll just get lost. We're going to take our base head and clean it up for the MetaHuman plugin. A few things to keep in mind here. If your mesh has teeth, a tongue, or an inner mouth, you should delete it. I find it can cause some issues and outright break the identity solver. Next, you're going to want just the shape of the head, so remove any hair cards, eyelashes, anything that isn't the face, head, and neck. For this model, the hair is all a part of the head, so we're going to do a little bit of sculpting to remove it. Try to imagine your character bald here. I'm just going to smooth out around his hair and use the grab tool to flatten it where I imagine the skull is. With that out of the way, we can focus on one other thing. The MetaHuman plugin requires textures on your mesh to distinguish different features. This mesh's textures will work fine, but we need to help it a little bit with the eyes. So I'm just going to paint some basic eyes on to give it a hand. If your character's eyes are closed, you should do your best to make sure they're not, or they won't turn out quite right. If your character has no eyes, then you should fill in the gaps the best you can. Otherwise, MetaHuman's gonna have problems. We also want to make sure the face is in a neutral pose. Well, that's out of the way now, so we can work on the scale. This doesn't need to be exact, just make sure it's not the size of a building. Cave here is just gonna be half a meter tall. Yeah, that's fine. From here, we can export it into an Unreal project. Use your standard FBX export settings. OBJ also works and will be faster to import if you have a very high poly mesh. Make sure new materials is selected on the import, and it should hopefully add your textures to it if it finds them. Otherwise, you're going to need to export them to Unreal and plug them in manually. Now right-click in the content browser and select MetaHuman, and create a new MetaHuman identity. Name it after your character. With this open, under Components from Mesh, select your head. From here, we're going to change the lit mode to unlit. Now under the Camera tab, decrease the FOV of the camera and adjust the position to see your face head-on. Quickly under Body, select Mesh. Then select Neutral Pose and click Promote Frame to save this camera position. Then hit Track Active Frame to let Unreal automatically detect features. Unreal did a good job here, but we're going to fine-tune some things. Go in close and adjust the position of each point so it matches up better. One thing to notice here is that Cave's face isn't completely neutral, so you can see his mouth is a little wonky. I'm going to sculpt this a little bit more. I can open up Blender and just adjust this, re-export, and it should automatically re-import, since I exported to this project directly. I do delete the frame here and retrack it, but you do not have to restart from scratch if you find an error later. Just swap to the free cam and back to see it update and adjust the curves accordingly. The key here is make sure that the points are pretty symmetrical and well centered. Now to check how Unreal will handle this, click MetaHuman Identity Solve at the top. Now we have the second mesh stored in the B view. Take notice of Cave's ears here. They're quite broken, so I'm going to add another frame to give the solver some more information to work with. Select the free cam and align it up to the side of his face. Now hit Promote Frame to add a new frame, and make sure to lock the camera by right-clicking on the frame at the bottom, or hit Track Active Frame and it'll lock automatically. We're going to only enable a few features as active, the visible nostril and ear. You can see the ear here is very mismatched. Take some time to position it correctly. Once that's finished, I'm going to adjust the nostril position a little better to match the contour. Then I can hit Identity Solve again and see how things worked. This came out pretty good. Sometimes you may notice that Unreal doesn't quite symmetrize things correctly after adding a second frame, and you may need to go back and add another frame from the other side. Just follow the same steps we did if need be. If any other features are broken on your end, make sure the relevant features are active on the mesh and aligned correctly. Some features like the eyes have more detailed parts hidden by default that you can use to fine-tune results. Check, double-check, and triple-check for any more asymmetries or errors. Cave looks great, so I'm now going to hit Mesh to MetaHuman at the top. Once it's sent through the backend, you can load up MetaHuman Creator on your browser. You may notice the model looks slightly inconsistent with Unreal, but don't be fooled, this is just an illusion. MetaHuman Creator uses pretty damn low FOV for its camera, so there's a lot different distortion here. Edit the selected mesh. The first thing we're going to look at is the Custom Mesh tab. Pause the animation and look close to the eyes and mouth especially. You can notice the eyelashes on Cave's eye here, as well as the liquid around his eyes and ambient occlusion mesh aren't quite aligned right with his eyelids. We can fix this by selecting the eye region and just adjusting its influence until they're aligned correctly. Adjust the different parts of the mesh here. Reducing region influence can give more natural but less accurate results. Just use your best judgment. If need be, you can hit Enable Editing at the bottom to enable the use of MetaHuman Blending and the Sculpting tools to get more control over things. From here, it's just standard MetaHuman stuff. Set up the skin color and adjust everything until it looks right. It's a good idea to put a reference to the side so you get more accurate results. Part you may have trouble on is finding hairstyles and textures that fit your mesh. You may just have to import the model into your editor later and give it your own groom and paint job. For now, I'm just going to pick the closest styles I can find. Cave does end up looking a bit more like a blonde Abe Lincoln here, but I'm pretty happy with how it turned out still. Check through the facial animations to make sure everything's working correctly. Depending on how stylized or extreme your mesh is, you might still see clipping happening, especially with the teeth and gums. And if you want to use this mesh in a production, you'll just have to edit the mesh manually outside of MetaHuman. You should now be complete, however. You can now export this to Unreal from Quixel Bridge, and from there, do whatever you like with it. If you have troubles, feel free to leave a comment in the description and I'll do what I can. Have fun!